keeping my body heat tight.
Thank you.
afternoon. Welcome to our Christmas Eve family mass. Today is a day of joy. The birth of Jesus brought joy to the world. It brought joy to Mary and Joseph, the innkeepers, the shepherds, the angels, and the wise men. Today, we all share their joy as our religious education students and their families reenact this joyous event. We hope that you will join in singing the songs during the gospel play. We ask you to silence your cell phones as we welcome our pastor and father, Tom and Deacon Len. Please join in a moment of silent reflection as we prepare for today's liturgy. As we stand and greet those around us, please be especially welcoming to our visitors.
In my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my fall, through my most grievous fall. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Our Lord, you have made your nation stronger. You Because of you, its people are glad and celebrate, like workers at harvest time, or soldiers dividing what they have taken. You have broken the power of those who oppressed and enslaved your people. You have rescued them as you did from Midian. For a child has been born, a son has given to us, and he will be our ruler. His names will be Wonderful Advisor and Mighty God, Eternal Father and Prince of Peace. His power will never end, and peace will last forever. He will rule David's kingdom and make it grow strong. He will always go with honesty and justice. The Lord, all-powerful, will make certain that all of this is done. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Titus. Brothers and sisters, God our Savior showed us how good and kind he is. He saved us because of his mercy, and not because of any good things that we have done. God washed us by the power of his Holy Spirit. He gave us new birth and a fresh beginning. God said in Jesus Christ our Savior to give us his Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Christmas began when all human behavior cried out for God's help, and so God sent us a Savior. A young woman named Mary was praying at night when an angel appeared. The time was just right. The angel said,
"Hail to you, Mary, so full of God's light."
And she asked, "Will you give to humans a great older brother? God's son is to come, and he needs you as his mother." "Oh, yes, Lord, I'll do it with joy," said Mary. The angel replied,
"Then soon a baby you will carry."
Joseph the carpenter and his donkey came right on down. And promised to take Mary to Bethlehem town. Meanwhile, the innkeepers were busy. The rooms were all full, and Mary and Joseph needed a space, but door after door was closed in their face. No room at the inn, no place at the table, until someone cried,
"You should try the stable!" Shepherds were tending their sheep in the night. When they heard angel music and saw a great light. Star, they heard angels sing, "Rejoice, everyone, at the message they bring." Nations afar come hurrying round at the sign of the star. This child is hope, a hope, a good for all nations, they said as they bowed down in glad adoration. Shepherds and kings. and the new baby boy. Christmas is saying, O Prince of Peace, come. Help us love one another and make your world one. Christmas is God's love for the people on earth, the day that we celebrate Jesus' birth.
There are different characters here, right? There's different parts of this drama. For example, of the angels. What were the angels' job, if you think? To bless Jesus, right? And to get us to sing. I think the angels not only got to be with Jesus, but they got us singing with them too. Whenever we sing the Gloria or the Holy, we sing with the saints and the angels. And so we got to watch how the angels bless Jesus and be around Jesus and sing like a love song, a hymn of joy to Jesus. Right? Good. And then we have the innkeepers. What was the innkeeper's job? They take care of your inn, right? But your inns were kind of, were they open? Were there vacancies? No. So then Mary and Joseph had to go somewhere else, right? And then where did they end up going, though? Yeah. To the stable, right? And that was a very simple place, wasn't it? A very simple place where, what usually happens in a stable, Carlos?
Animals
get raised, right? And there's Jesus, right? We're all animals. We're fed. And that's a great reminder, too, of how Jesus came to us, not with like a lot of riches or fancy garments, but he came in poverty, took on flesh. And he was born in a manger where the animals would feed because he gives us life. He's like our spiritual food. He gives us his own body and blood. Beautiful gift of the Eucharist, which we're sharing today as we celebrate his birth. So that's good. And the shepherds, can anyone tell me what the shepherds' jobs were? To manage the sheep. And I can tell that the sheep needed some management, right? The sheep, no, they were very orderly. And what was your big line? I kind of heard it. It was really good. Excellent. Yes, that's probably the best baa I've heard in a long time. Very good. Good job. Who else? How about the three kings? What was your job to do? Yeah, to give gifts to Jesus. And that reminds us too that, you know, when we celebrate the gift of the Magi or the gift of the three shoes, that every day we're asked to give our very best to Jesus, to open up our hearts, our lives to Jesus, and to do our very best. So everybody did their best and to do their best. All of us, adults and children alike. That's the greatest treasure that we can give to Jesus. The star shining brightly, of course, Mary and Joseph were there. They had a big role, didn't they? Anyone want Mary or Joseph share what your big role was? I bet Mary and Joseph were very good at loving Jesus. They were good at welcoming Jesus into their lives and loved and cared for him very much. And that's what we're called as well to do. And of course, Jesus was a very special, big part of it, of course, right? And I think he played a great role. She did a great job. She's communicating out to us in this nativity scene. So we congratulate her as well. So anyone else want to share? So good job. You remind us that bringing this beautiful story to life before us makes us want to be a part of it. As we kind of take a peek at what Jesus' birth was like, we're kind of like taking a selfie, right? We're getting in the picture with Jesus. And he invites us in at Christmas. He invites us in every day, of course, but at Christmas, we're invited to come in and to take a peek, to come in and to get to know and to love Jesus by offering our very best of ourselves, no matter what part we play. Everybody has a part to play in the gift of love, in the gift of salvation and life that God offers to us. So today on this Christmas, we look at the Nativity, we reflect on the beauty of God's love and God's mercy, and we ask God to help us from this day forward to share that love, that light, and goodness with each other, with heartfelt compassion, with kindness, patience with each other, in our families, in our friendships, in our parish community. So again, congratulations and thanks for really helping us pray together and see this beautiful display of Nativity for us this afternoon. So again, congratulations to you.
Our needs and those of the whole world.
for true, lasting peace throughout the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church, that as we celebrate the birth of the Lord, she be renewed and strengthened in his love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who suffer and have sorrow, that they find a Christ child and be filled with joy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the healing of the sick, the ill, for those in hospitals and those who care for them, especially those who we now name, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died in the Lord, especially for those who we mention in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intention of this Mass, Connie Rigney, deceased members of the Wintick family, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray for our families and friends and for our intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all military, past and present, let the Lord watch over them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, forever we rejoice today in the gift of your only begotten Son, who leads us from darkness to light, from sin to redemption, from death to eternal life. Hear our prayers and grant them in your mercy to the one whose birth we celebrate today, Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Lord, hear us.
Prayer to let you go to Paul's church.
As we look forward, O Lord, to the coming festivities, may we serve you all the more eagerly, for knowing that in them you make manifest the beginnings of our redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new life with glory has shone upon the eyes of our life, so that as we recognize in Him God invisible, we may be caught up through Him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, thrones and dominions, hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Together with Francis, our Pope, lays our bishop and all their clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, your spouse, blessed apostles, and all the saints who have reached you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await with blessed hope the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Drop off. Thank you.
we pray that we may draw new vigor to celebrate the nativity of your only begotten Son, by whose heavenly mystery we receive both food and drink, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
I just want to thank everybody. This is, of course, my first time celebrating Christmas with all of you and celebrating the family mass. It's very beautiful, and I want to congratulate everyone who helped put this together. So thank you to all of you. Everybody at your home and with friends that you meet, so you know that as well. And our blessings today we received, we're going to go forward and to share it. So thank you. A big welcome to everyone today. We just have a couple of announcements.
The Sacrament of Reconciliation and Beacon Masses resume their regular schedule next week at both sites. Please note that due to the holiday, our hospitality weekend will be held January 7th and 8th. If you or someone you know could use some food support at this time, the monthly fresh produce distribution will take place in the parking lot of St. Isaac Joe's on Wednesday from 4 to 6. Please come and share this information. Please come or share this information with someone you know. If you were not here with us last week, please accept the Christmas gift for your household from the parish books. The books, titled Wisdom of the Saints, are at the doors of the church as you leave.
Bow down for the blessing.
May the God of infinite goodness, by the incarnation of his Son, has driven darkness from the world, and by the glorious birth has illuminated this most holy night. Drive far from us the darkness of vice, and illumine our hearts with a light of virtue. Amen.
Amen.
God, who willed that the great joy of his Son's saving birth be announced to shepherds by an angel, fill our minds with gladness he gives, and make us heralds of his gospel.
Amen.
And may God, who by the incarnation brought together the earthly and heavenly realm, filled with the gift of his peace and favor to all of us, and make us sharers with the church in heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, come down upon you and remain with you forever and ever.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
These children singing Joys of the World on page 340.
Get the cross. That's why.